Hello and welcome. I'm Lynn Trapp, and I am pleased that the National Association of Pastoral Musicians has invited me to share this brief presentation of music as we celebrate Holy Week and Easter 2020, during this time of crisis in our world. As musicians who minister publicly, we need to understand that our well-being is very important if we are going to serve others well. Throughout my career, I've learned that as we feed others, we must make it a priority to also feed ourselves as leaders, as performers, as those who engage others in worship and music. Now, that seems obvious, but making time to do it is often a challenge. We have to open our hearts and minds to receive, to give, and to reciprocate. And in that exchange, I believe we are shaped as who we are truly meant to be. And creativity is a very important part of this goal. Our creativity should include time set aside to improvise, to create without boundary, to hear ourselves without limit. For example, create some melodies and harmonies that are only yours. With your voice or instrument, improvise how you feel at a given time. Look at a sacred image like a stained glass window or an icon and play and sing what you see. Make it up and allow yourself to do that without limit. No one is keeping score. My experience with teaching keyboard institutes and connecting with many fine performers of various musical disciplines and abilities, from beginners to conservatory-level study, is that many times a person can achieve the highest level of repertoire and technique, but not know what it is like to create music that is not written down. Even just the thought of trying this exercise is very frightening to many. For instance, have you ever just sat down to sing or play Majesty? And so forth. I didn't know what that was going to sound like until just now. Or how about Agony and Suffering? And so forth. I didn't know what that was going to sound like until just now either. And each and every time, it's going to sound different. When we free ourselves for greater creativity, we can then fuse our human feelings and creativity with the dynamics of our worship music. And now we specifically connect to the most powerful time of the liturgical year as experienced in Holy Week and Easter, including Majesty, Communal Banquet, Suffering and Dying, Watching and Waiting, and Triumphant Resurrection. These dynamics are all experienced in our daily lives and help connect our life to liturgy, which is rooted in the Paschal Mystery. When we give deeper feeling to the sound and shape of our music making, it allows our inner self and spirit to radiate God's message more purely, more freely, and to truly connect life with worship. To articulate a simple time of meditation for the Holy Thursday banquet, I would like to play two organ meditations. The first is my own arrangement of Take and Eat by Michael Jonkis. And the second is based on the chant Ubi Caritas, arranged by Gerald Neer. And now a time to create. Music which weaves the melodies of three pieces and connects to the celebration of Good Friday. When I survey the wondrous cross with the hymn tune Hamburg, when Jesus wept, the famed early American tune by William Billings, and Jesus the Lord by Rock O'Connor.
Thank you.
From the 11 organ chorale preludes of Johannes Brahms comes a mournful setting of a tune which we know as the Passion Chorale, O Sacred Head Now Wounded. In the next piece, which I have composed, entitled Images of the Exultet, the chant melodies of the Easter proclamation of the Great Paschal Vigil are sewn together. In an effort to paint the darkness, the emerging light of the Paschal candle and the candles of the assembly, the proclamation itself, the sounding of the trumpet of salvation, and a triumphant conclusion to the piece featuring the last phrase of the Exultet chant, may the morning star which never sets find this flame still burning. Join me now on this journey.
Thank you.
In essence, then, every piece of repertoire was first an improvised creation by the composer and then written down. I'd like to conclude our journey today with the music of J.S. Bach and play the fugue from the Passacaglia in C minor. I normally do not excerpt this piece, but in the interest of time today, I will play just the fugue, which is based on the same melody as the Passacaglia. It is a trip through briars, peaks, and valleys with accumulating variations on the ground-based theme, much like a tour through majesty, agony and suffering, watching and waiting, and then triumphal joy. The piece ends with a thunderous C major chord, bringing one of Bach's crowning pieces and our time together today to a conclusion of hope and joy.